Line on Gawker says Gawker likely to sue over two-year conspiracy to hide Hillary emails. The Associated Press this week, just a couple days ago, said they too were going to sue over getting access to those emails. Where does that stand in terms of a lawsuit by Gawker?
So we are filing probably today a lawsuit prepared by Mark Zaid and Bradley Moss, two attorneys that we're working with in Washington, D.C., over we're going to file. We have one active request with the State Department, which is for email correspondence between one of Hillary Clinton's top aides, Philippe Raines, and reporters at a list of about 34 news organizations, because Philippe has been known for his sort of colorful email exchanges with reporters and a very brusque and some would say bullying style. And how he manages the press. That was his job at State Department, was to deal with reporters. So we wanted to see how he did that job on behalf of the American people, which is who he worked for at the time. So we filed a request for back in, I believe this was a 2011 request, actually. And we received an absolutely preposterous response from the State Department. They had no such records, that there were no emails between Philippe Raines and reporters at the New York Times, at the Wall Street Journal, at CNN, at every major news organization. We appealed that request, and State Department said it would continue to search for any such records. And this, you know, years later, they're still searching and they haven't turned them over. Now that we know there was a plot at the highest levels of the State Department to shield email communications from senior staffers. And remember, this is not just Hillary Clinton who had one of these email addresses. Huma Abedin, one of her top aides, also had a ClintonEmail.com address. As far as we know, Philippe Raines actually did not have one. He says he did not have one. But we are told and have reported that he did use non-governmental emails to transact state business. I don't know if he handed those emails over to the State Department as he was supposed to. Maybe he did, maybe he didn't. But now that we know that there was this effort at the top to frustrate the efforts of FOIA requesters, we're filing a probably today, if not today, we'll get it in Monday, for those records.
John Cook is the investigator.